Hello everybody, and welcome to my video on candle magic. I hope you enjoy this video. I'm gonna explain a little bit about what candle magic is and how we can use it to shift energy and to help bring stuff into our lives and also to absorb negativity and get rid of stuff out of our lives. This is my altar at the moment. I burn candles quite a lot because I just love candle magic.
Hello everybody, how are you going? So I finally am getting my candle magic video up. It's been a while coming, I apologize, but I finally got my tripod, so that's made my life a lot easier because now I can do these sorts of videos. So today I'm talking about candle magic. Candle magic is just awesome. I just absolutely love it. Candles have been used throughout the centuries. They've been used for so many very different things. They are used from providing light for people back in the Middle Ages, through being used in ceremonies, religious and non-religious ceremonies, for celebrations. Candles have just been part of our lives for so long that I don't think anybody can ever really point a time when, well, probably way back when, but they've just been an everyday part of our life. When we get blackouts, we grab for the candles, all that sort of thing. So candles have been a very big part of our life. Now, candle magic is about using the power of candles to shift energy. And that's what candle magic is. And there's lots of different things that you can use candle magic for to move energy. It can either remove negativity or it can help bring and manifest something in. So there's two uses for candle magic, and you can also just use candles because you love to burn candles. I mean, I burn candles all the time. I have some tea lights behind me at the moment because the candles I normally would use I'm going to be showing you anyway. So the sorts of things that candle magic can help you with is things like facilitating healing and putting you into good health, helping you with self-growth. It can help you overcome negativity, and it can also help shift things around a negative situation in your life, shift the energy around that. It can also help to remove blocks. If you have any blocks anywhere in your life, you want to remove them, it can do that. It can help with clearing chakras. Chakras is a really big one. If you're a person that's into meditation and into energy work, and you know that you've got a chakra that's not working well, then you can burn a candle that's the same color as a chakra to help shift and remove that block. It's got a whole gamut of range that you can use in candle magic. It's just absolutely awesome. I'm going to run through now the different sorts of candles that you can get, because there's a huge variety. When I decided I was going to make a video on candle magic, I thought, okay, I need to buy some candles. So I started looking around and I was really amazed at the variety that you can get. So I'm going to show you some, and I'm going to sort of tell you what they're best used for. So the first one I'm going to start with is this guy here. Okay, this is a pillar candle. Now, pillar candles are mainly used for altars. Like, you see my altar behind me? I will use these on that. The reason these are best for altars is because they're big and they will burn slower. Okay, so these are best used for if you want to use it on your altar. Also, these are good because these are better because, you know, you've got to be constantly putting them out, relighting them, putting them out, relighting them. You can, if your person's attuned to Reiki or Sashim, you can still put your symbols on these if you choose to. I know I put Reiki and Sashim symbols on mine. Even though you're putting them out and you're relighting them, they still will work. They still will put that energy out there. So I still do that with these ones. So yeah, these are pillar candles. They're best for altar work. The other sizes things you can get is you can get smaller pillar candles, like this guy, and it doesn't matter whether they're scented or they're not. It's a personal preference. If you like scented candles and you want to burn scented candles, fine. If you can get candles that are scented using essential oils, It is better, mainly just from a personal thing. Anything, you know, that has chemicals in it is not always a good thing to use. Things that tend to use more natural ingredients are better. So you can, you know, use scented candles if you want to. You have this size, and you can use this size for shifting energy. This is still small enough that it's big enough, but yet small enough that you can, it will burn in a reasonable amount of time for you to shift energy. You've got these guys, which is another type of pillar candle. These guys are also good. You can write on these and you can use these for shifting energy. You've got smaller pillars, you've got a skinnier one, which can do exactly the same thing. You can, it will burn down lovely and in a really good period of time. You've also got things like, you can buy things like, now I found these all in discount shops. I live in Australia, so we have the Reject Shop, we have Stax Discount, which it's only, I don't know whether it's been down south, but it's only just recently come up to where I live in Brisbane. Well, I've only just discovered it anyway. They have a lot of this candles, they have a lot of Calib candles in them. All your discount variety stores that you see, like your cheapy shops, you can get a range of really good candles in those. You can buy candles from Target and Woolies and things like that. Maybe more difficult to get coloured candles, but they're readily available. So you can buy coloured candles in this size. I have a purple one as well in this size. So you can use your colours that way as well and burn that down as well. I also, whilst hunting for candles, came across this one. This one is a multi-layered one. It's awesome, absolutely awesome. It's got pink at the bottom. It's a green, sort of going with a thin layer of like a blue going through to a thin layer of green. Then there's like a yellow, and then there's like this purpley brown on top, I think you would call it. Now, you could burn that and use it to shift a few things if you wanted to. It's really up to your own imagination what you do and how you do it. Okay, the candles are just the tool that you use. Then you've got this is what I use a lot of dinner candles. These are great. These burn down. Taper candles are great. They burn down in a very short space of time. And you also have the little violet candles as well. I keep everything in here. These guys as well. This is a black one. It's actually meant to be scented with a lavender scent, but you can buy coloured candles in all sorts of sizes. So this is another guy that's a really good size to use for doing this work. And like I said, taper candles. You just write on the side of these and away you go. So I tend to use taper candles as my main go-to when I'm doing any sort of candle magic work. They're the ones I will work with the most. Now, when you have your candle, the next thing you need to do is you need to clear it. You need to clear it from everybody else's energy. So what you do is you get some white sage incense. I have white sage. And, I thought I got the matches out. Oh, hang on, I'll use the candles behind me to light it. There you go. Oops, hang on, I'm not doing so well here. There we go. It's lighting now. Cool, it's lighting now. Good. Cool. Okay. Here we go. Whoops. So, you smudge it. So what you do is you just get your candle and you just run this over the candle like that. Okay? And that clears it of any other negative or anybody else's energy that's on it and any other negative energy that could be attached to it. So that's what you do. One thing I wanted to talk to you about too is the colours, the different colours that candles come in and what they mean. So the saging you tend to do before you write on it, but I'll talk to you about candle colours now. So the first one you've got, I don't have all of them, is black. Now I have lots of black ones. These ones came from Target, but I have another box of black ones. I burn a lot of black. No, it's not because I have heaps of negativity around me. I just find they're really effective. I burn a lot of these for other people as well. So I do a bit of candle magic for other people as well when they ask me to do it. You can do it for other people if you wish to. But so I have done it for other people. So black gets rid of negativity. Black gets rid of darkness returns back to darkness. So black will absorb negativity. It'll get rid of negativity. You can use it for banishment. You can use it for the shadow side of yourself if you want to. Yes, I'm looking down everybody because I can't remember all this off the top of my head. I've got some notes written down, so please excuse me. And if for ending of relationships and partnerships, now you've got brown. Now I don't use all these colors, but brown is to do with animal protection. It is to do with the earth energy. It is to do with roots and ties, and it grounds you. It's a very good grounding color because trees are brown, so it's a really good, you know, grounding and centering color. And you can use it to help you with any deep healing that you need done. You've got dark blue. Dark blue is a really good color for depression and vulnerability and mental health issues. It can help in those sorts of areas with sort of moving the energy around, that sort of thing. If you're feeling slightly depressed or you have anything else like along those lines going on, you can use a dark blue candle. Gold is, of course, money. It's for financial gain. Gold is also to do with business endeavors, and it's also to do with solar connection, the sun, because the sun is gold, so it's connected with the sun. Green, now I have a green one. It's a little bit sort of used. Well, not completely. It's just I think it's a candle that fell apart on me. So green is really good for abundance. Green is our abundance candle. So green is also, as well as abundance, it is for healing as well. Green is good to use for healing because healing. Green is the healing color. So money, good luck, fertility, and yep, that's about it. Sorry, just reading my notes. Money and luck and fertility and healing and abundance. So green's the one you can use for that as well. You've also got light blue. Light blue is to do with health. It is to do with patience, intuition, and peace and understanding of the flow of energy as well. So that's what light blue, you use white blue for. Orange is a really great color. Orange is a happy color. I like orange. Orange is a very creative color. I love orange. I always imagine if I want to be really creative, I imagine being surrounded by lots of orange light. So orange is to do with fertility, creativity, growth of your self-esteem, confidence, abundance of all kinds, and independence. Excuse me while I just flip here for a minute. I've just, like I said, I've got notes here that I've been reading. Pink, one of my favorite ones. Pink is to do with self-love. Okay, it's to do with friendship, it's to do with compassion, self-acceptance, empathy, joy, and gratitude, and lifelong relationships. So pink is also known as your love color. Little pink candle. That's what pink is for. You also have purple, and I have a purple one. It got a bit bent with the heat during summer, and that can happen to your candles, trust me. They can get a little bit bent. Purple is to increase your enthusiasm, desire, power. It's also a spiritual, purple's also a spiritual color, so if you want to connect more deeply to your own spirituality, purple's a color to use. So it's about all forms of expansion on what you already have as well. All right. Silver is moon energy, that beautiful moon, and we're coming into a full moon soon. We're in July, we're coming into full moon soon. It is to do with moon energy. It's to do with ancestors, contacting your ancestors if you need to know something. Purification, if you're a person that's into astral travel, it helps with that. And it also helps with your dreams. So silver's a great color for that as well. Then you've got beautiful, gorgeous white. White is a universal color that everybody knows. It stands for purity. I tend to burn when I'm just having my altar just candles to burn, I will use white candles. I use coloured candles for specific reasons. But if you like coloured candles, you can burn coloured candles, but I use white most of the time. My go-to is white, or maybe cream, but you can still use that as well. Like cream is still okay to burn in place of white if you want to. So white is to do with purity, it's to do with motivation, it's to do with the divine inspiration. It's also to do with seeking of truth and spiritual matters. And it's also contacting and helping you get in contact and help you connect with your higher self as well, plus your angels and your spirit guides as well. So burning white candles can help you with all that as well. Now yellow is a really cheerful color. It's a happy color. It's another one of my favorite colors. I love bright, cheerful colors. It's about personal power. So it's all about personal power. It's about confidence. It's about success. Of course, I've already said it's cheerfulness, and it's also to do with, helps with increasing your intellect as well. So that's just a very interesting little side note as well. Also, burn two candles together. Now, I do a lot of that. The combination I tend to burn together is black and pink, and that's why I've got these guys here. If I am burning a black candle to absorb negativity and to remove it, or to remove negativity around a particular situation, I will always burn pink. Now the reason I burn pink, because pink is one of the highest vibrations for love. So when you burn a black candle, you're removing something. You're changing and you're removing something, you're taking something out. So you can't just have this void, this hole of nothingness. You have to replace it with something. So you replace it with the highest vibration of all, love. And love is the highest vibration of everything. Everything is based around love. And I'm talking about universal love. I'm not talking about romantic love. I'm talking about universal love. So whenever I burn a black candle, I will always simultaneously burn a pink candle as well. You can burn two candles together. If you're burning another color and you feel drawn to burning another color beside it, you can do that. Pink is always a good one if you want to just bring in love. Green and pink to do with healing and bringing in that love energy to help with that healing. That's another really good combination. White and pink, you know, your spirituality and your love, spirituality with your white one, you know, pink, you know, with your love energy. So you can do that as well. So that's another thing that you can just do if you choose to. All right. So once you've saged your candle, which I showed you how to do to clear your candle, I'll just quickly sage this over here out of shot. What you do is you can buy, the best I've come to find is bamboo skewers. Your bamboo skewers that you use for your meat, you can buy them very cheaply. You get a bamboo skewer, and if you're a person that is attuned to Reiki or Sashin, you can put your symbols on the side over the candle. I usually write that. I mean, there's no right or wrong, okay? I tend to write that way, but some people like to write down that way. It's entirely your choice. I just tend to go across that way on my candles. That's just my personal preference. What you do is you can write, if you're doing it for a person, you write their name on it. If it's for yourself, you write your name on it, you write it down. You can write, usually your full name is best. If it's for another person, you can write their name on it. Now, you can also use this for your pets as well. And trust me, it is not that crazy. Animals are energetic beings, just like we are. So if you have a pet that you think is not well, you can burn a light blue candle. If you have a pet where you know, or if you have a rescue animal and you know it's been a really negative situation, a really traumatic, you can burn light candles for them as well. And it does work. It seriously does work. I have had a few people who I have taught how to do this, and they come back to me and they go, oh my goodness, wow, it really worked. And I went, yep, it's so simple, but yet it is so effective. It's one of the most simplest and easiest things you can do. And that's why I love using it, because it is simple and it is really easy to do and it's effective. Sometimes if a situation is really very heavy, you might have to do it more than once, but that's okay. It's about the intention that you use. Right? It's really about the intention that you use. So once you've written on your candle, what you then do is you can hold it in your hand, you take some deep breaths, and you center yourself and you imagine drawing down the universal energy within, centering yourself, thinking about what you want to use your candle for while holding it in your hand. And once you've closed your eyes and you've breathed a few times and you've sent that intention and put it into that candle, and you feel like you're done, then you can light your candle. Now here's just a little safety message. Please make sure that if you're going to be burning candles, that you're going to be at home, okay? It's wisest to be at home when you do this. If you absolutely have to go out, I mean absolutely have to, there's no choice, and you want to go out, it is best not to put the candles out. What I would suggest is to go and put them in possibly the bottom of your shower recess. If you really need to put your candle out, then fine, put it out. You know, that's okay. But that is just another thing you can do. If you want to just put a bit of water in the bottom of your shower recess, as in just wet it, and then put the candle, you know, the candles and whatever you have them in, like the holder, you have them in like this, in just sitting along the bottom of your shower recess, you can. When you light the candle, you then just drip like that, and you secure it into the bottle. Now, I tend to use really big candelabras. The taller, of course, the better. I only have one of these ones, as you can see. This is great. This is a really good size because, as you can see, 3/4 of the candle is contained inside. But I will use these ones because this is still, and I put it smack bang in the middle. You can nowadays get your little battery candles, the ones that you see a lot in the restaurants these days. They're very effective too, and you can actually program them to do something. You can actually program them. You can program them and you can set an intention for these guys to do something. And it's really, really, really good. So once again, you just hold it in your hand, and if you have some symbols, you can draw, if you've got a pen, you can probably draw symbols on the bottom. But you just hold it in your hand, and you could sage it, and then hold it in your hand, and just think about what you want it to do. And you just say, I want this candle to do this. And then you can turn it on and use it. So you can also use the little battery operated candles as well for that. However, every time you want to use it, you have to clear it from the last time that you used it, from what you last programmed it. Clear that. So you can just hold it in your hand and just say, I now clear you of all past programs, and clear it and sage it again. And then you can reprogram it again. So you can use those candles for that sort of thing as well. That's about all there is to candle magic. It's really easy. There is nothing to it. It is so easy. Yet it is very, very powerful. It is a really easy process, but it's a really powerful process. And that's why I use it so often. I use it all the time. I use it, you know, when I need to use it. I love candles. I love candles. The other thing is too, they're not too expensive. Like this one here was I got it from Indian bargain shop, and it's It was $3.50. This guy here, it was $4.50. This one doesn't have a price on it, so I can't remember. Actually, these guys, that one doesn't have a price on it. I can't remember how much that one. These guys actually came in a pack. I'm sure you can see tea light candles wherever you go. I know the Reject Shop sells them, and I know Target sells them. Target has about 100 for $6. That's how I buy them. You've also got this little guy too, which I just discovered recently. Now, this guy, he's not a tea light. I've never seen these before. However, he only burns for about an hour. So unless you wanted something to burn really quickly, I would just use this on your altar as a little light type thing. You could use it, but it doesn't burn for very long. The ideal burn time is roughly about these guys, about 4 to 7 hours, I would say, is probably a good burn time for being able to shift stuff. I will put some links below in the description. There is also a beautiful company in New South Wales, in Nimbin. It's called the Nimbin Candle Company. I will find that and I will link it's their website below. Hello everybody, I'm back again. My camera decided to stop recording, so I'm just finishing off my video. The bit that it decided to cut out on was me about explaining that I'm also going to be linking a video below, another video on candle magic below in the description. It's a really good little video as well. So if you've enjoyed this video, please give it the thumbs up. If you like this video, also please share it with your friends so other people can get to see it as well. That would be really awesome and it would really help my channel grow. My channel is still fairly small, so by sharing this, it helps my channel grow by letting other people know that I have this channel here with this sort of content on it. So everybody, no matter what you're doing, please have a good day, a good evening, no matter where you are. Stay safe, and I will see you in my next video. I'm not sure what that's going to be yet. I just felt and knew that I had to do my candle magic video first. I knew that was going to be my very first one. I have a list of other stuff I want to do, other content I want to do. I haven't decided what I'm going to do next. So until we meet again next time, thank you very much for watching my video. I do appreciate it, and I will see you again soon. I'm in Telfo. Bye, everybody.